Hello, my name is Jackie Rees, Assistant Director of Patient Safety. In the next few minutes, the safety team and I will guide you through the incident reporting process and explain why this is so important. Let me introduce you to the safety team. The team is led by Dr. Paul Murray, Chief of Patient Safety and Deputy Medical Director. Our roles include patient safety and improvement, incident reporting and risk management. We are here to help and listen to your concerns. Some of you may have reported an incident in the past and some of you may have concerns about doing this or may not be aware of what happens after an incident has been recorded. An incident is something of concern that either could have resulted or did result in harm to a patient, staff or visitor. It's important to know that even a near miss could be recorded as an incident. We can still learn from these types of events, and this will help us take action to prevent future harm. A serious incident requiring investigation, commonly known as a SIRI, can be an incident which resulted in severe harm or death, or where there is significant learning. These investigations are governed by a national framework. SIRIs are reported to the Clinical Commissioning Group and then to the Care Quality Commission. There are strict timescales for investigating these and they need to be completed in 60 working days. As with all incidents where there has been harm to the patient, they need to be informed of the investigation within 10 working days and kept updated throughout this process. This is often referred to as the duty of candor legal process. Our team previously carried out a survey. You may have seen this advertised on Aspire. We wanted to understand your concerns about incident reporting and use this information to make improvements. We've learned that some of you are unclear on how to report an incident and you're unsure whether any action will be taken as a result. Some of you feel that it's time consuming and you would appreciate more feedback on what action has been taken after an incident has been reported. We have listened to your concerns and have been working on ways to make reporting easier and ways to ensure that you receive better feedback once you have reported an incident.
If you have been involved in an incident or have witnessed an incident, think RUG. If you have a concern about patient care, even if there has been no harm, think RUD. If you have concerns about your working environment, think RUD.
It is very important to remember that when you record an incident on Datix, the information is used to make improvements and is not used to blame individuals. In this example, a doctor has been having a discussion with a patient, but then leaves the case notes in a public waiting area. Although the notes are handed safely to the receptionist, this is still an information governance issue that should be reported on Datix. Here we can see that there has been a delay in a patient receiving medication due to the difficulty experienced by the nurse in accessing the drugs cabinet. Reporting issues like this can help get them resolved. In this example, a doctor is about to recommend treatment for a patient using information from the wrong set of notes. Although this is a near miss, reporting incidents such as this can enable us to put safer systems in place to prevent a more serious incident occurring in future. First of all, find the TrustNet internet page and click on Report an Incident on the top right-hand corner of the page. This will take you to the Datix system, which looks like this. Then you need to click on the Report an Incident button. You will then need to fill in a few details about your concern. If you are unsure, there are lots of help sheets on the system to guide you through the process. Just remember, record on Datix! If you would like to know what happens after an incident has been recorded, you can go to the Patient Safety webpage on TrustNet, where a further video is available.